Next is catch-up of day. I hate this level. Because it has hooks. There's so many hooks that will cost your life. Although there are some you can ride on, as Patrick demonstrated. Then again, this is inspired by the episode Hooky. But they will hurt you. All I know is that I hate this level with passion. But now that I got a jellyfishing net, I can do it to deal with those jellyfish in case I have either a float bubble or a bounce bubble. What's also horrific about this though is that even the hooks up there will hurt you. Just look at those tips shining like that. Up, and those dumbo scallops are back. I don't know how long this video will take to finish this level. If it's too long, then I'll have to make another one. Which means I will have to make 4 videos today. Wait, is there anything down there?
Nah.
This is also another level that gives me a hard time to find all the doubloons. And there's a sea enemy again. Trust me, you will get hurt real easily in this level. It will cost a lot of your lives. I already died twice in this game. Once in Rock Bottom and the other was in Alaskan Bullworm boss battle. Although I haven't gotten a game over. I only have 7 1-ups, so I'm fine. Oh, got a bounce bubble. That means I gotta get my jellyfish net. See? They're gone. Well, not really, they will still come back. Which is a real annoying part about these jellyfish. Cut that out. And it turns out I was right about those sea urchins. They only appear in 2 levels. One in that under a boardwalk level and that desert level. And also it turns out these sea enemies only appear twice as well. See, those hooks up there can hurt you as well. I hate that. any bubble can get rid of these hooks. It doesn't have to be the normal or the strong ones. The normal one, I mean the bounce and the float ones can get rid of them as well. Just a little tap of any bubble will make those hooks get lost. Now, is it this area? Or there might be some secret passage in the bottom somewhere? Let me just float down for a little bit and take a look. Hope I don't land on somewhere. Ah, there we go. You don't want to miss that part. Come on. Oh. Durr. There we go. Oh, SpongeBob, I didn't do that. I found a key animation. I guess it's because I got it at the same time I got the doubloon. Ah, whatever. Oh, this part's nasty. Best to do it with your normal jump than that strong jump. There's the next key and just need one more. And there's the final key. Just need to find if there's any bubbles I need. Nope, that's just a sponge. Well, I do give this level credit for having that amount of underwear. I just need a couple more doubloons. Let's hope I can get them all. Whoa! More. Well, they already got a strong bubble. Well, I mean, I guess that makes sense if I accidentally got the float bubble instead of not breaking those barriers. There's a rodeo again, and that's pretty much the last one. Well, in this part. And there is the last treasure. Ancient Sword of Enchantment. And I got 100% on the doubloons. I'm on the 10-minute mark, so I have plenty of time to do the boss, Wild Jellyfishing. So here's what we do. And I got another underwear, so I got 7 now. First, get rid of those small ones. Whoa. First, we need to get those small ones, which is a shield. And I'm already dying. That's just great. Better duck down so I won't get... There we go. Then you have to hit it with a bubble. Oh, careful with that part. You can use a bubble to get rid of its electricity. Is the attack. Like, if not, then you had to avoid it. Just keep hitting it like this. Ah, I got him. Oh, Patrick. Wait a minute, did I miss something? I kind of sworn I got him. I could have sworn I completed everything, because there was supposed to be a new chapter right around here. Ah, whatever. I'm sure I can fix that. Okay. So, tomorrow once I get this all complete, we'll be going to the final level.